Exactly. Yeah. You know, our offense, obviously, we made some improvements, and I don't think it had really anything to do other than us. It had, I mean, I'm not going to say Friendship's defense is better than Tascosa's or anything like that. It had a lot more to do with us and the way we approached the ball game. Not necessarily that night, but I think it all started Monday, the way we approached the week. You know, like I said last week, you know, I think you can go through spring football and you can go through fall camp and kind of fool yourself into thinking you're better than you are, you know, and I felt like we fell victim of that and we're guilty of that. We thought we were better than we were. We went out and found out we weren't very good and we had to make some improvements very fast, and I think the improvements started up front. Our offensive line got better in our pass protection and our run blocking, which in turn caused our quarterback to play better, which in turn caused our running backs to play better, which in turn caused us to cause the passing game to open up just a little bit. So the improvements made up front were tremendous, and we just want to stay on that trend right there and keep improving up front.
I know you got to move forward, but the way you won that game, was that just a massive momentum builder for your
I think so. You know, I think it was, you know, it's kind of, we saw two sides of our, we saw two sides, you know, over the last 2 weeks. We've seen what we're capable of. On the wrong end of things, you know, we've seen we're capable of playing some pretty poor football. We've also seen that we're capable of playing some really good football, and that's, you know, I think that we need to build on that and continue to improve offensively, defensively. Yes, it was an emotional game. It truly was. I mean, there wasn't a play out there that wasn't just it. Total engagement from your players, from their players, from your fans, from their fans, from the band, from the cheerleaders. I mean, 100% total engagement. Hopefully we learn from that and are able to build on that going into the future, because that's really what we're here for in the non-district schedule, is we're here to learn about our team and learn where we're deficient and learn where we need to improve and make those improvements fast.
Coach, what did these first 2 weeks teach you about your team's mental toughness, losing the Friendship, going into a game where there's a lot of noise, entering this game with it being a rivalry, but being able to battle back from behind and ultimately win it? What did it show you about how mentally tough this
team is? We are mentally tough. We're a mentally tough group of guys. You know, I felt like we went into the Friendship game not very focused. I really did, you know. But, you know, little things like forgetting your knee pads and things like that. You know, if you forget your knee pads, you're not ready to go play. And I think we learned from that. Going into the Tascosa game, we showed some mental toughness. We showed some resiliency in our ability to fight back and not really get our head down and just continue to play hard. That's what I want to see from our team. I want to see us just, you know, it's hard for us to ask them for victories. It really is. We would rather ask our kids to give tremendous effort. We would ask our kids to show a lot of courage and work to improve on a weekly basis, and that's what we did, and we want to continue to do so.
Ryder's no picnic, you know. Rodriguez, no, their quarterback, K-State offer, have a D lineman who's Big 12 looking at.
That's right.
Lost to Azle, no shame in that game. Averaging 40 a game.
They're good.
What are you seeing them?
They're good. You know, it starts with them. You talked about the quarterback, and he's, you know, they're 500 plus yards of offense a week, and he's accounting for 88% of that. That's the number we found. So. It all goes through him. They've got good skill kids, though, that he can get the ball to. Defensively, starts with their defensive line. Their defensive line is talented. You'll see them, and we won't see a better-looking group of guys. What we've got to do is get those guys playing from sideline to sideline, get them tired, and I think, you know, the ball game, if we're able to do so, we'll find opportunities to win the game in the fourth quarter, because they're going to make us look bad early. We just can't panic. We truly can't. We've just got to keep them running from sideline to sideline and then try to win the game in the fourth quarter. You know, that's kind of our game plan. But they're you know, our non-district schedule has been tough. It truly has. But it's an opportunity for our team. That's the way we see it. We see it as an opportunity for us to improve and get ready for this district race, because there's really not going to be too many off games in this district.